Vedanta switching the attention from the changing thoughts to the changeless consciousness. And this turning the attention is possible only when the mind is a relaxed mind, a calm mind, and a subtle mind. A mind which is turbulent and which is extrovert, it will be bothered about the changing worries and the changing anxieties in the mind, but it cannot turn the attention to the changeless thought, and therefore a lot of effort is required to enjoy a relaxed mind. A highly dynamic, active, result-oriented, ambition-gripped mind wants to make use of every second and achieve this or that. That mind is not relaxed. Vedanta requires prashantasya. First of all, he should listen to the teacher. Adukke konjam relaxation vaanu. So, an extrovert mind cannot listen. Krishna tells, when the mind is relaxed, Paramatma, the Self, which is none other than consciousness, and when does it obtain? Pratibodha viditam matam. Keno Upanishad beautifully says, Atma is evident all the time. You don't have to go to a special meditation to experience the Atma. Just as I don't have to go to a special meditation to recognize the light, because the light is experienced in and through every experience. Similarly, consciousness does not require any special state of mind or any special meditation. It is all the time available. Therefore, Krishna says, samahitaha. Samahitaha means ever evident. And the beauty is, the person who has a relaxed mind, if you ask him whether consciousness is evident, or if you ask him when is the consciousness evident, that person will ask a counter question, tell me when is the consciousness not evident. In fact, missing the Atma requires effort. It is not possible. That's why he uses the expression sam ahitaha. Sam means what? Very, very clearly evident. And this recognition has to be done in two stages. The first stage is turning the attention from thought to consciousness, like turning the attention from hand to the light. Similarly, in our mind also, changing thoughts are there, changeless consciousness is there. Vedanta is shifting the attention from the changing thought to the changeless witness. This is the first part of the sadhana. Then there is the second, more important part. And what is that? When I recognize consciousness or turn my attention to consciousness, my tendency will be to say that I am the body-mind complex and I have consciousness. This is our initial approach. Who am I? I am the body-mind complex. And what do I have? I have the consciousness which illumines my thought. Now Vedanta says, you have to train your mind and reverse the approach. Instead of saying, I am the body-mind complex and I have consciousness, what should I do? I have to reverse it and claim, I am the consciousness principle and the body-mind complex is an incidental instrument used by me. This is the biggest shift and the most important shift. In fact, meditation is meant for this particular shift alone. I have to change my orientation. Because throughout, when I give my biodata is body-mind oriented biodata. I have to scrap that by knowing that is not my biodata. Then what is my biodata? Sthula sukshma karana shariraad vyatiriktaha avasthatraya sakshi panchakosha vilakshanaha sachidananda surupahasan yas tishthati sa atma. Remember the 5 points I gave regarding consciousness? Consciousness is not a part, product or property of the body. Consciousness is an entity distinct from the body, which pervades the body. Consciousness is not bound by the dimensions of the body. Consciousness survives even after the body goes, and the surviving consciousness cannot transact, not because it is absent, but because the medium of transaction is not there. This is the description of consciousness, and that consciousness is my nature. And this we can easily know through our day-to-day experience also. During sleep, we exist, but we don't transact. But the end of transaction is not the end of my existence. If end of transaction is the end of existence, what will happen? During sleep, I am dead. But I know during sleep I am not dead. I am very much alive, even though I don't do any transaction. Extend this to death also. After death also, I do not transact, but non-transaction is not non-existent. And therefore, I exist all the time, either with transaction or without transaction. Transactions come and go. The transacting instruments come and go. But I, the consciousness, am eternally unaffected. So this is called Atmajnanam. This is called discovering the real I. And this is called owning the real I. And when I own up this real I, what are the benefits I will get? Krishna says, Samaha Bhavati. We have to supply. Samaha Bhavati means this wise person is the same, unaffected by what? Shita, Ushna, Sukha, Dukheshu. This wise person is unaffected by all the pairs of opposites happening in his life, like heat and cold, favorable condition and unfavorable condition, none of them will shake him. And not only that, tatha mana apamanayo. Manam and apamanam is a very big issue. We are very much worried about our social status and respect. What will our children do? Ava ipidi pannina enna pandrathu, appidi pannina enna pandrathu. So we are not even bothered regarding children's future. We are only bothered what will happen to our name, our family's name, if such and such thing happen. That self-respect, that is so much that when that is affected by apamanam, there are people who even commit suicide. So thus, our life is constantly tormented by all these opposite experiences, and jnanam gives immunity against all this. Therefore, mana apamana yoho samaha bhavati, chita ushna yoho samaha bhavati, sukha dukha yoho samaha bhavati. Samaha means what? Unaffected. Continuing. Jnana vijnana triptatma. Kutastho vijitendriyaha. Yukta ityuchyate yogi. Samaloshtashmakanchanaha. So this disciplined person goes through two stages of self-knowledge. The first stage is called jnanam, and the second stage is called vijnanam. We have seen these two words in the third chapter also, jnana vijnana nashanam. While talking about kama krodha, we saw these two words, jnanam and vijnanam. These two words have got different meanings according to different contexts. I will give you a simpler meaning here based on what I said before. When you say, I am the body and I have consciousness, it is jnanam. So, consciousness is taken as part of the body and we take ourselves to be the physical body. This is called jnanam. And why it is called jnanam? Because at least I know that there is consciousness. Because I am at least saying I have consciousness. Minnala aduve seriya therinjirukala. So at least I know this much, that I am the body and I am endowed with consciousness, which is a distinct principle which pervades and illumines the body. And then what is vijnanam? Vijnanam is, instead of saying I am the body and I have consciousness, I change it and say, I am the consciousness principle and I have got this body as a temporary instrument of knowledge, like the spectacles. The spectacles have got these two glasses. When I put on, I am able to see and transact with the world. When I remove the spectacles, I don't transact, but remember, I continue to exist. In the same way, our body and mind are like the two glasses of the spectacle. And when I use the body and mind, I have the waking state experience or dream state experience. When the body and mind are relaxed and resolved, then I don't have waking and dream state. Therefore, I don't have any transaction. But even without transaction, I continue to exist. And therefore, body and mind are more an instrument than myself. And this attitudinal change, the change of identification, is called vijnanam. The first is like paroksha jnanam, the second is aparoksha jnanam. And only when the shift take place, jnana vijnana tripta atma, only when I shift my I or identification from the body to atma, then alone my sense of limitation will go. People may ask, why should I shift my identification? I am happy to claim I am the body. Why should I know the atma and thereafterwards struggle and drop my identification with the body and develop a new identification with atma? Why all this headache? Why can't I identify with my body itself? For that, Vedantic answer is, if you are comfortable with body identification, wish you all the best. We are not interested in changing your identification. But the problem is, as long as I am identified with the body, there is the first fear of mortality, the fear of old age, the fear of disease, the fear of death, not after 50 or 60 years, but it is a constant companion throughout the life. And not only we are afraid of our own death and old age, we are afraid of the death of the near and dear ones. In fact, samsara is fear of death. And some people may say, I am not afraid of death. Then I will say, it is fear of old age. Then some people may say, I am not afraid of old age also. Then I will say, it is fear of disease. All these are called samsara. And if you say, I am comfortable with all this fear, you don't require Vedanta. But if you say, they are affecting me, then better handle this problem. And unfortunately, there is no medicine which can cure all the diseases. And if at all there are medicine which will cure diseases, they in this process will produce iatrogenic diseases. You know, iatro or iatrogenic diseases means diseases caused when you take treatment. So you took a medicine for headache, and the headache went and stomach pain came. Or still worse, headache continues and stomach pain was added. There is no medicine for all diseases. There is no medicine for old age. There is a science called gerontology. How to stop aging process? And all the gerontologists are old now. And many of them dead also. So studying gerontology, they grew old faster perhaps, I don't know. And there is no medicine which can immortalize the body. For these three basic problems, there is no remedy. So if you are willing to face this problem, wonderful. Otherwise, better come to Vedanta and discover the fact that you are something higher than this decaying body, this changing mind. You are Nitya, Shuddha, Buddha, Mukta, Swabhavaha. Ever free, ever eternal, ever undecaying, ever secure, ever beautiful, ever full, higher I. If you want to discover, Vedanta says, may I help you. You know, in the railway station, there is a board, may I help you. What is this counter for? Not to go after any person. If anybody wants help, it will be given. And what is the solution? The only solution is, you have to discover the Atma, which is different from the body. Then what is the benefit? Maja, maja, you know? The life is relaxed. No fear of death. Imagine, no fear of old age, no fear of diseases, because they belong to my incidental shell of the body. They do not belong to the real me. Jnana, vijnana, triptatma. Tripta means contented, happy, fulfilled. And vijitendriyaha, who will be able to get this knowledge? Vijitendriyaha, only the person who has mastered himself. Mastered himself means mastered the body-mind complex. That person alone will become jnana-vijnana.